Hey, MzeroA Nation, Jason here, bringing you another great part of our aviation weather series. Again, all this month, the YouTube videos, the podcast, the member-only ground school webinars, all related to this topic of aviation weather. Today, we're talking about icing conditions. Now, we know for the majority of us, the aircraft we're flying, say flight into known icing conditions is prohibited. Why is that? Well, with ice, there is no quicker way to add weight and spoil the aerodynamic flow over the wing, all while adding drag. If I told you I'm going to increase your drag, increase your weight, ruin that nice aerodynamic flow, that lift generating capabilities of your wing, that's not something you would sign up for. Yet that is exactly what ice does to our aircraft. Now, there are essentially three main types of ice. There are some subcategories here, but the three main types you need to know and understand are as follows. They are clear ice, rime ice, and mixed ice. Let me show you a great animation of all of these. First off, clear ice. Clear ice forms when supercooled water droplets hit the leading edge and essentially run back over. The plain English word they use is run back ice, you'll hear it called sometimes. Clear ice forms a sheet over the aircraft. Clear ice adds a ton of weight relatively quickly. Next, we have rime ice. Rime ice is a brittle-like structure, much smaller water droplets, very opaque in nature, that hit and create this brittle look to it, rime ice. While rime ice may not weigh as much as clear ice, if you compare the two, it certainly spoils the aerodynamic flow much quicker. And then there's the combination of the two, called mixed ice. Some larger supercooled water droplets, some finer mist or smaller, or even worse, freezing rain can cause mixed ice. Now, also with clear ice, you can get a weird phenomenon called ice horns, where you want to talk about how we really spoil the aerodynamic flow over our wing. Look at what ice horns essentially do, and you can find images of this all across the internet here. Icing is nothing to mess with. Whenever we encounter icing conditions, it's instantly, I'm reporting it. I'm getting a PIREP out there immediately so other pilots can know there is icing that exists at these altitudes. How do I get out of icing conditions? Well, usually it's a change in altitude. Oftentimes I can even climb through it. In order for there to be ice, there has to be visible moisture. If I can get up on top, well, I may not shed all the ice off of me, but I'll stop accumulating it. And I can always descend as well. The thing I'm looking for is I'm looking for warmer air. This is why it's so important to be checking and watching where the freezing levels are. Remember the damage that happened to 23 Mike Zulu back in Oshkosh? Well, it took a while to get all those repairs done, and 23 Mike Zulu was ready to go, ready to come home after its little thing mishap that happened at Oshkosh due to a tornado. It was ready to come home, yet every time we looked at where the freezing levels were, this is January, we're looking to bring the airplane home from Wisconsin back to Florida, the freezing levels were at the surface. For weeks on end, it seemed like. I'm sure many of our Midwesterners can relate to this, that there's not a lot of flying that happens when the freezing level is down at the surface. It's important to know the three types of icing, but it's important to know how to avoid it as well and where the freezing levels are. If that's something you want to learn more about, I encourage you, at the end of this month, I'm doing a free live stream, a live weather analysis. It's Thursday, April 30th at 3 p.m. It'll be on the MzeroA YouTube and Facebook pages. And I'll be doing just that. We'll plan a fictitious flight, we'll brief it, and we will analyze the weather with you live, making smart go and no-go decisions, speaking about it from a VFR as well as an IFR standpoint. We're not going to pick an easy route. We'll pick a route that day that truly has some weather that we need to contend with and be able to ask your questions, and we'll bounce ideas off one another as well. So Thursday, April 30th at 3 p.m. on the MzeroA.com YouTube and Facebook page. Now, there is a link to RSVP as well to let us know that you're coming and get reminder updates in the description below and above this video. Also, if you have not signed up for Aviation Mastery at Sea, I encourage you to join us. Independence of the Seas out of Fort Lauderdale, October 26th through the 31st. My good friend Steve-O-One Knievo is going to be joining us as well for some outstanding aviation seminars. And of course, our highly anticipated co-pilot course. This isn't just a, hey, come on the cruise by yourself. We want you to bring the family. Bring your spouse, your partner, your non-flying friend, whatever that may be, so they can go through our co-pilot course with you. This isn't some pinch hitter course, what happens in an emergency. This is how can we exercise crew resource management to be an asset to one another in the cockpit. They're working the radios and pulling up four flight charts while you're flying the airplane. That's where we want to get your non-flying spouse or partner. That's the pace we want to get them up to. So check that out as well, aviationmastery.com to check that out and learn more. Look forward to seeing you on the live stream. Look forward to seeing you on Aviation Mastery at Sea in October as well. Can't wait to read your comments below this video on YouTube, on Facebook, and on MzeroA.com. Enjoy the rest of your day, and most importantly, remember that a good pilot is always learning. Have a great day, guys. We'll see ya. Take a 2-week free trial of our online ground school and see why Aviation Consumer Magazine named it the top online ground school on the market. The first thing you'll notice is that we never teach to the test. We teach real-world skills that are going to keep you and your loved ones safe when you fly. Now, it's because of this real-world teaching, you'll pass your knowledge test and your check ride with flying colors. With one membership, you get access to all our courses, plus weekly webinars with myself and this outstanding MzeroA.com team. It's really like an interactive TV show broadcast from our studio, where you get to interact with a team of CFIs. We also offer live support and email support to make sure you succeed. Now, one thing you'll notice is that MzeroA is like nothing else on the market. It is truly a flight training community geared towards making you a safer, smarter pilot, because a good pilot is always learning. It's much more than a slogan for us. It is truly a mission. So click below and take a 2-week, no strings attached trial of our top rated private, instrument, commercial, and FOI courses. Once you join our flight training community, I promise you will never want to leave.